Welcome back to the channel. In this video, we're going back into time.
What we're gonna do right here is go back, way back, back into time.
In this video, we're discussing what flying was like in the 1970s. We'll go over just how much public air travel has changed in the past 50 years. Traveling by air has become the second most common mode of transportation in the world, but this wasn't the case back in the 1970s, as traveling by airplane was not cheap. In the early 1970s, many people did not see it as a safe means of transportation, although today it is considered the safest mode of transportation in the world. The average price of a ticket in the 1970s was around $500, which is roughly about $3,000 today. However, these flights were priced this way due to all the bells and whistles. In the 70s, travelers were allowed to walk freely in the aircraft. Even if there was turbulence, they enjoyed meals and would look like small restaurants. The bathrooms were quite spacious and looked more like bathrooms that you would see inside a house rather than how bathrooms look in normal planes today. These sections were inspired by luxury train wagons from the 1950s. Once again, the planes didn't need to have a lot of seats because there were only a handful of people that could afford to use air travel as a means of transportation. As time passed, the airline industry became hungrier for profit by turning common planes into containers that could fit as many seats as possible and having separate planes for business and first-class passengers. Another major leap for commercial air travel in this decade came with the introduction of the Boeing 747, a wide-body jet aircraft able to carry many more passengers than its forerunners. Here, the American First Lady Patricia Nixon sprays champagne onto the aircraft ahead of its maiden commercial flight from New York to London in service with Pan Am in January 1970. In some airliners, the lounge even had a piano or even a full music band for entertainment. Some of the bigger airlines, such as the Boeing 747, even had a few separate rooms with full-size beds. Spiral staircases connected two decks. Widescreen movies were played in the cabins for more than 500 passengers in some configurations. Airlines suddenly had room to breathe, dream, and design their wildest ideas. In the 1970s, the party never stopped. American Airlines removed 60 seats from its luxury fleet of 747 jets in order to build a lounge large enough to fit both a piano and a bar that served complimentary cocktails. Another interesting fact compared to today was that passengers were allowed to smoke on board. Now, of course, today, smoking inside a plane is completely prohibited, just like anywhere else. Here are some of the services that came with flying in the 70s. A lounge area, tables and chairs, silverware and crystal, a portable altar on Sunday flights in case you miss church to get on a plane. Praise Jesus. Few things are more of a letdown in life than scoring a window seat aboard a plane that doesn't actually line up quite right with a window. The average leg room in the 1970s was 34 inches. This number, as opposed to the 32 or even 28 inches offered by some airlines today, aligned perfectly with the windows of a plane so that each row was sandwiched exactly between two windows. You're not gonna get that today. With all things considered, though not as comfortable, regular flights are much cheaper today due to the Deregulation Act in 1978 in the United States. Many scholars and professionals suggest that airline deregulation drastically transformed the airline industry throughout the world, and that airline deregulation of the United States in 1978 lowered the average airline fares, removed unnecessary government regulations. However, shrinkage of seating space like we just talked about, termination of free in-flight meals, charging of checked baggage and preferred seats, and reduction or cancellation of the number of flights from the small hubs are a few examples of the issues of service quality. Fast forward to today, how do you feel about airline companies to back then? Do you enjoy taking commercial flights, or do you see it as a stressful experience once you hit the airport? Let me know in the comments, and let me know your thoughts about how flying was in the 1970s. Feel free to like, subscribe, and see you on the next video.